Welcome to another episode of Tinkerine Experiments. Today we are going to be printing with another exotic filament, silk filament. We were given this filament for testing, so let's find out whether or not it works. Today we will look at whether it prints and the wear and tear on the nozzle. We can see that the silk filament has a kind of gloss to it, and it's more silky looking than a regular PLA. It is also a lot more flexible and stretchy than the regular filament. It's taking me ages to break this small part off. Before we start testing the materials, let's measure our nozzle diameter with our Extrude Wizard. Oh, it looks like the nozzle diameter is right now at 0.45 millimeters. Now let's start out with the test print. So far, it is adhering to blue tape. I don't see any problem with it. It's printing like normal PLA. It doesn't look like it is gonna run into any problems anytime soon. The test print finished with no problems, so now let's print with our gem print and see if any problems rises up with a longer print. It's sticking well just like the test print. I don't see any problems with it. It doesn't look like there's going to be any clogging or anything that's going to happen to your print anytime soon. It's finished. Now let's take it off and take a look at it. It pops off the bed relatively easy. Now a closer look to it. I don't see any imperfections on either prints. They both look pretty good. Also, it looks like it retained that same gloss even after printing. I thought it would be a bit different after it goes through a nozzle and being heated up, but I guess not. The two print looks pretty nice. Now let's do the Extrude Wizard once again and we'll check the diameter. For some reason, the nozzle diameter is 0.47 to 0.48 millimeter right now. I'm not too sure what they have inside this filament, but just to be sure, I would say there's a plus or minus 0.01 millimeter from our caliper. Well, there we have it. We tried printing with silk filament, and as we can see, it does work, and the product actually came out looking pretty nice. There's not much of a wear and tear on the nozzle like the bronze filament that we tried earlier, but there is just a bit. But this little bit could lead to overextrusion in the long run. That's the end of our experiment today. If you liked our video, please give us a thumbs up, and if you did not, then a thumbs down below. Remember to subscribe and comment on what experiments you would like to see in the future. Thank you for watching. Tinker out.